Hi, it's Kadidja Yansane of bloomintoyou.com, and I'm so excited to be interviewing Celia Ward Wallace, who is a soulful business coach, and she's the founder of the Superfly program, which is an online business program that teaches female entrepreneurs how to start, grow, launch their online business. And I took it, and I can't recommend it enough. Yay. She's also the author of A Woman's Guide to Having It All. She trains people to become coaches. And on top of that, she's been married for almost 20 years and has two children. So yes. Welcome, Celia.
Hey, I'm so excited to be with you. I just adore you, Kadidja. You know that. Mm. And you've been such a beautiful light inside of the Superfly Soulful Business Program. And now you're a graduate and now your business is booming. And so just so excited to be with you and your audience today.
Likewise. Is there anything that I didn't say that you'd love to add?
Well, I think probably like a lot of your ladies in your community that are listening, we're all multi-talented, multi-passionate. And so there's a lot of things that I do. But I think for right now, what I've really been encouraging my Superfly ladies and my community to do is focus on one main thing and really go deep with it, see it through to fruition. And so for right now, my biggest baby is the Superfly program. And like you said, it's for women who are either 9-to-5ers and, you know, feeling like they have so much more potential and purpose in their life, but they're not sure what it is. And they're interested in starting maybe like a side hustle is what I call it, or, you know, their first business or their next business. Or for ladies who are maybe 1-to-5 years into business and have something up and going, you know, they have a little bit of a following, a little bit of a list, but they feel like, you know, maybe I'm missing some pieces here. This isn't quite working the way that I thought it was. I want more flow. I want more alignment. And really, I also want some of the higher level strategies that help you figure out how to begin to make money in your business. And so that's what I focus on right now is the Superfly program. But like you said, there's many things that I do. And really, I just love my work and love to serve.
Yeah, it so shows. Can you tell us a little bit about the process of you creating the program?
Yeah, so I started as a coach 5 years ago. I was certified by the company that I'm now a vice president of, which is Certified Coaches Federation. And so we teach an intensive about 18-hour course. And that was the course that I became certified in. And then after I became certified, I really went after the CEO of that company and said, I want to do this. You're from Canada. Let me be in charge of the California region, which after a bunch of training, I did. And so since then, I have been training and certifying and helping coaches grow their businesses for about the last 5 years, working with over 1,000 different entrepreneurs. And from there, I went back to my 9-to-5 where I had been working already for 13 years. And I decided it was time to leave the 9-to-5. And I went on to work there for maybe like a year. But the whole time I was there, I was definitely working on how to make my transition. And then I made my transition. And so that will be about 4 years from now. In November will be my official, you know, since I've been on my own, a full-time entrepreneur. And the first couple years in business, I sort of did what was typical and certainly typical for a lot of ladies that I work with, which is initially feeling like there's so many things I want to do. There's so many different directions I can go in, so many different types of people I want to serve. And so doing a little of this, a little of that, and sort of being a generalist. And luckily for me, I was very good at what I did. I wrote my first book. I created some coaching programs. I did a lot of speaking. And so I definitely got some momentum and lots of affirmation that I was in the right direction. But it wasn't until about 18 months, maybe, it will be 2 years in the fall that I started to get this idea about the Superfly program, which was really an A to Z, you know, soup to nuts program that you would get for spiritual entrepreneurs or aspiring spiritual entrepreneurs. So women who are heart-centered, service-minded, spiritual, soulful women who want to create these amazing businesses and purpose-driven businesses to make positive impact in the world, like me, basically women just like me. And initially it started with a mentorship where it was like 12 women at a time in a group coaching, online group coaching with me. And then I did a few classes of 12 women at a time. And then last spring or last winter, I did a big launch of the program where I changed the model a little bit so that it would be able to scale, which I know a lot of your listeners may know what scaling means, but it's certainly something that we talk a lot about as you grow your business, which means you take your idea, your concept, your work, but you start to figure out how you can do that and have more people work with you for the same amount of energy and time that you would spend working with one person. For me, I was working with 75 women at a time. And so I got a lot of affirmation that there was a demand for this type of work in the world. And I created the Superfly program. Like I said, first I worked with 75 women at a time, which you were in that class. And it was just amazing. I mean, absolutely beyond imagination, wildest dreams, you know, life come true, dream life, dream business experience. And now I'm about to launch again. We're opening the cart to the next class. It's going to begin. Open cart will probably be like September 28th or, you know, in the next month or so. And then the class itself will begin October 12th. And so that's my journey. Well, that's the business journey. I had a whole lot of journey before that.
Well, it's a beautiful journey. And I know a lot of women viewing, like finding out your niche can be such a challenge. So how did you tailor in on the niche of working with women entrepreneurs?
Yeah, and even more so spiritual entrepreneurs who want to do online business. And so a lot of what I teach is how to go from your broad niche, which might be, I want to work with women, to what type of women, you know, and narrow it and narrow it and narrow it until you have a very refined niche where you can become, where you can create visibility and influence in that niche and become somebody that people really know the name of. Because as we all know, there are so many other people out there in the world doing similar things to what we do, which is really beautiful, because if we want to change the world and make positive impact, and there's a bunch of other people that want to change the world and make positive impact, I'm all about that. I believe in abundance. I believe there's enough for all of us. But one of the ways that we can stand out in business is by refining our niche and refining who our, what I call our soul client is, so that you can begin to say, no, I don't do all of this. I don't do all of this. I don't do all that, but what I do is right here. I work with soulful, spiritual female entrepreneurs who want to launch their online business. That's exactly what I do. So if you want to do all these other things, I'm not the coach for you. But if you want to do this, damn straight, I am the coach for you. And I'm also going to tell you all about who I am, all of the stories of what I've been through, show you as transparently as possible what type of person I am and what I stand for, so that you can make the most you know, really eyes wide open decision about whether I'm the mentor for you, because there's a lot of brilliant other people out there that might do what I do, still help spiritual entrepreneurs launch online business. But if you feel a connection to me, I'm going to be the person that you want to work with. If you feel a connection with that other mentor, then they're the person you want to work with. And so for the women that I work with, the goal is for them to look at their life experience, look at everything that they've been through, all the twists and turns and things that they have unique knowledge in. They've gone through something that they really know a lot about. You know, they have lived it. And whatever that is that you have so much knowledge in that you could talk endlessly to somebody in line at Starbucks or somebody at a birthday party, you would just be like blabbing away, giving so much advice to them. And if that aligns with your greatest gifts and talents and passions, sort of to combine this whole little formula to then say, okay, this is who I'm going to serve. And then what are their greatest problems that they need solved? And do I have an associated skill set to provide that solution to them? Because obviously we're working on a concept of, you know, supply and demand. And so you have to be finding a niche that is actually, you know, has a demand for what you're creating. Because just because you want to talk about how to make beautiful floral arrangements, per se, if nobody wants to know about how to make beautiful floral arrangements, then you don't have a business. But if you find out that women want to know how to make floral arrangements on a budget where they could spend $10 a week and get it delivered to their home, you know what? You might have a great service-based business where if you can start shipping women, you know, bouquets once a week so they can have beautiful flowers in their background on their videos, you know, now you got a niche. You know what I mean? So you're refining, you're refining, you're refining until you really have a strong niche.
Well, one of the things that I appreciate about you, Celia, is just how authentic you are and how your program really reflects all your unique interests and your unique skill sets and how you teach that. And one of the things I notice is that you're really visible with your business and transparent. And, you know, I know visibility is a big thing for new coaches. Is that something that you had to overcome?
Well, I've always been an open book. That definitely is my style. I'm a talker by nature. I love people. I'm always, you know, I am sort of the life of the party. I am the ultimate wing woman. Like if I go out with my friend, thank goodness I'm married now because I used to be a man magnet. Like, you know, I definitely know how to attract people. I know how to engage with people. I know how to connect with people. And I'm confident by nature because my parents are still full-time civil rights organizers. So I grew up in an environment where my parents were leaders in the community, fighting for justice, fighting for equality in a very diverse community of all different types of races and ethnicities and cultures. And because of that upbringing, I was very trained to be confident, to be outspoken, to own my power and all of that stuff. And so, but now what I know is I'm uniquely skilled in that. Right? So my ability to be transparent, you know, like I posted a video last week about, you know, everybody knows I love my husband. I talk all the time about I love my husband, but then sometimes my husband drives me crazy, like all husbands, right? So I could have an issue with my husband and go, oh, well, I don't want to tell anybody about that because they all think my husband is so great. So what if I tell them that my husband was a jerk tonight? You know, is that going to make them judge me or not want to work with me because I'm not perfect? Where I believe it's the flip side. You want to show your imperfections. Now you don't want to show, you know what? I'm trying to teach you how to run a business. I don't know how to run a business. You know, right. That's kind of imperfections. But if you really are teaching people how to run a business and you're good at running a business, but it doesn't do good to just be like, and I have my schedule all figured out and I do everything perfectly and I always look beautiful. And every time you see me, everything's perfect, 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 mm-hmm. because you create a gap between you and your audience where they go, I mean, some people like that, sure, but most people feel like, okay, I get it, everything looks good, but there's something where I'm not having a soul connection, right? And so for me, like I just did a video this week about, you know, it was my second day back at work since summer, and I'm literally working at 5 o'clock at night, which is not a big deal. I had already taken my kids to school, worked all day, picked my kids up, brought them home, set them up with their homework, and now I'm back in my office working, and my husband comes home and immediately gives me this mad attitude about, why are you working? You know, we didn't create this business, you know, for you to be working at this hour. Mm-hmm. It's all about freedom and lifestyle and stuff. I'm like, you're preaching to the choir, and I love my business, and I'm in a launch. So, and I'm just back from the summer. I'm 2 days in. Do you know how much work I have to do right now?
Yeah.
Like, you know, the last thing I need is for you to be sweating me. But all of that to be said, like, I had this really strong trigger, and I was processing that, and then I had the realization, if I'm having this really strong trigger, other people have this really strong trigger too, yeah. I should shoot just an off-the-cuff video. So I went with my kids and my husband to soccer practice, and here I am, no makeup, you know, I don't look like this all the time, you know, hair, baseball cap on, sunglasses on, you know, just at soccer practice, and I'm like, I'm just going to shoot a video right now telling them what I went through and encouraging them not to let their spouse stand in the way of realizing their dreams or pursuing their purpose and passion. And I knew in my heart that that would resonate, but it wasn't until I put it on all the different channels and groups I'm in and all this stuff that I was like, holy crap, like this struck a chord, because all of a sudden now I'm getting 20 comments, you know, all these new likes, private Facebook messages. I have people emailing me off of one video, off of one post, but it was because I was willing to say, I'm not perfect. My husband is not always nice, or not, doesn't always get my business. And, but you can do this. And people were like, yes, you know, thank you. And so I really try to encourage my community to do the same thing, because that's been my number one tool. You know, I just did a survey in the group about like, what is it that you like the most about me and my brand? Like, what makes you fall in love with me and my brand? And I listed 10 different things, and it could be my business knowledge, my style, my my spirituality, my connection to God, my realness, all this kind of stuff. And number one by far was, you are real, you are approachable, you are transparent. And I realized, I mean, I already knew that, but it was like affirmation of like, okay, keep doing what you're doing. People want to see this. It's encouraging so that they can then do the same thing.
Yeah. I saw that video and I loved it. And it struck a chord with me, and I saw all the comments. And so I'm so glad that you brought it up, because there is that juggle of working and wanting to be successful in your relationship and balance life with kids. Like, what's your secret to balancing a successful relationship and your and motherhood and this successful business?
Well, my secret is I'm really clear on what I want my life to look like and what I want my lifestyle to be like. And so what I work with my ladies on is creating that dream life and that dream business, and being really clear on what your values are and creating everything in alignment with that. So for me, I want ease, you know, I want freedom. I don't want stress. I don't want conflict. I don't want to do things I don't want to do. And I want lots of spaciousness with my time. And I want very clearly defined time with my family. And so in general, my schedule is seven. I drop my kids at 7 in the morning on the bus, and I pick them up at 3 from the bus. And so from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. Monday through Friday is my time. My time to figure out how I'm going to spend my time, right? And I can create whatever I want to do with that time. Any time beyond that is a time where my family starts sort of giving me some, you know, side eye, looking at me crazy. And usually if I'm going to do like a launch, I know I'm going to be at night or things like that, I may tell them in advance, you know, say, hey, mom's going to be working for the next month harder than normal. I'm going to be working more nights. I might not be able to go to every soccer practice, but you know what? Because I'm getting ready to do this launch and do this program that I love and serve these women that I love. And your support means everything to me. And it would really make me feel great if you would just support me and not give me a hard time about it during this time, because I need every ounce of positive energy to really live this dream, right? So I get, and then like after the last launch, when the last launch went so great and there was like a big influx of money, I took them all shopping. You know, I took them on a shopping spree and I said, we're going to buy a bunch of, you know, I'm not a big materialistic person, but I like to buy nice things, you know? So I took them new tennis shoes, new swimsuits, like all the stuff for our summer vacations. And I said, and this is a result of the money that I made from the Superfly program. And I made it very clear to them, mommy pursued her dreams. You guys supported me. And as a result, I have this money now to pay for our vacation in this summer, to pay for these nice things that we have. And I really want to create that connection between you live your purpose, you have the support of your family, and then you generate revenue, and then you can reinvest your revenue into your business, into your community, and into your family. The other two things, or a few things I just want to say on that is, my husband and kids are my priority. And so I definitely spend a ton of time with them. And Mike, I am really present with my children, and that is where I find the most purpose and the most positive experience is the time that I spend with my family. And so, and then with my husband, we go on a ton of dates. You know, we love going to get foot massages. We love to go to the movies, and we love to have sex. You know, so we are intimate. We talk all about our days, you know, every day we talk all about our days. So he knows all about the Superfly program. He knows all about my ladies. He might be like to nauseam, like enough already. I don't need to hear every detail, but every time I get a testimonial or every time something cool happens or something bad, he knows all the twists and turns. So he's an active participant in my dream. And he understands what I'm up to. And so I have his buy-in there. And so really, but also I cook, you know, and so I feed him, I have sex with him, I tell him how great he is. And other than that, you know, we have our conflict and our challenges, like all marriages. Yeah. We're very different. So we definitely have our conflicts. But I would say all in all, I feel like I'm a really great wife. I'm a really great mom. And then my business came along and it became my third child. And now over the last years, I've just been raising it. You know, it's just like it hasn't hit five yet, you know. So it's like still I'm in the baby stages. Mm.
Well, I love that. Just the importance of buy-in, whether it's your husband, your partner, your children, your friends, like when people feel included in your dream and they get, and you communicate along the way, then they feel like they're a part of it and not like it's something that you're doing on your own. So that's so, so important. So I know that soul care, self-care is central to your business. Can you tell us a little bit, like, what's the difference between a soulful business entrepreneur and being just a business person?
Sure. Well, I know you and your women's community is a lot about, you know, divine feminine power and pleasure and really aligning ourselves with these beautiful gifts that have been given to us by God, you know, that are resonating through our body. And if we have all these tools, this intuition and, you know, the moon and all these different things that are so cool that we can leverage to really keep ourselves aligned, then I know your community already sort of gets it. But what we've been taught is this patriarchal, white male focused form of business, which is like just, you know, work really hard. You got to work, you know, 50 hours a week, 70 hours a week. It's all about making the money, you know, and don't get me wrong. I do believe money has to be like one of the three pillars of what you're doing in your business. You have to be financially focused. But you don't start a business so you can make the money, or it's not all about the drive for the money. And it's like hit the ground running, you know, work from the moment you start going until the moment you crash in the bed. And so, and for me, especially for women, that's not a sustainable model. You know, women need to recharge. They need to take care of their temple, their body, their soul, their spirit. And when we finally wake up to the fact that we have all this power and this greatness within us and that we can take care of ourselves and it just gets better and better, then, you know, it's revolutionary. And so what through business, through soulful business, I believe it's really about the fact that if I say I have 7:30 or 7 to 3 to work, then the first 2 hours of my day are spent taking care of myself. And I can create that however I want, depending on how I'm feeling, right? I'm paying attention to my feelings, letting my feelings being the guide. Some days it might be, I need to go back to sleep, right? That's rare, but I did go back to sleep last week and it's because I'm back to the new schedule. I'm getting used to the new schedule. But for me right now, it's like I need to get movement. I need to get some exercise, whether that's doing Koya or doing yoga or doing stretching or walking or going to take a spin class, like I've gotten back into my spin classes. Then it's what's my connection to my spirit, to my source. And that manifests in a lot of different ways. Sometimes when I do the walking, I get the 2-in-1, right? Because I'm out in nature. And for me, when I connect with nature is when I feel the most connected to my source. And so that is definitely like a stacking functions. I get exercise and I get my sort of spiritual connection. But I also have a beautiful altar. I also have a beautiful backyard and I will just sit and I will journal. I will do some EFT, emotional freedom techniques, some tapping. And it just depends. There's everything that I teach in the Superfly program, there's like a wealth of variation of what you can do. The point is that you're trying to do something, right? It might be, I'm going to get my nails done. Like my nails are busted. I need to go get a mani. You know what I mean? I'm like, it's time already. Mani-pedi has to be on the roster of self-care for the week. But the more that we realize that our business success comes from being self-focused and enriching ourselves and making ourselves and our worthiness and our self-care and our connection to our why, which comes from our connection to our source, that is where the biggest success in business comes in. Because now we're creating all this alignment. We're creating all this flow. We build our confidence. We build our self-love. And then that trickles out into everything that we create because our audience can feel it. They're picking up on it. And the energy that we're sending out, we then receive.
I love that. And I love how the financial piece is such a pillar of the program because I speak with a lot of heart-based professionals or healers, and they still have this fear around accepting money for their services. And so what would you say to that?
Well, I would say money is one of the pillars of energy in the universe, and you know, whether we like it or not. And so if you don't pay attention to your finances and generating money, cultivating money, loving money, tracking money, then you're sort of cutting off one of your limbs, right? Mm-hmm. You know, so if we focus on the energy within our soul as our life force energy, and then we focus on our work, you know, as, you know, that energy that we're putting out into the world. And then we focus on our money, you know, how are we generating money and how are we cultivating money? The whole program, although it's all about self-care, soulful practice, is, and you can testify to this, is probably the most comprehensive business course on the market. And so we start from nothing of like, well, what do you think you want to do with your life kind of thing? And are you sure about this business? And really making clear of what you're going to create, all the way through to giving you every single step and tool and tutorial and action plan and everything to literally create. And if you've already created it, to launch a online program or in-person program or whatever. It's not just online. We have modifications for what you can do in person. But it's very much moves towards, you have to have a plan for monetization. And one of the things that you have to get really clear on is, if you go from a place of what is your niche, your signature platform, your sole client, and you start to think about what are the pain points that they're suffering with, what are the solutions that you can create in the form of a service or a product for them, and then focus on just that, and create something really amazing and valuable and tangible for them, then there's a bunch of different ways you can deliver it. I mean, you can deliver it in one-on-one, you can deliver it in groups, you can deliver it in evergreen products and online courses and all these speaking engagements, books, all this different stuff. But now you got to create modes of getting paid. Okay, now that you've figured it out, you gotta be like, you gotta tell people that you do this, and you have to position yourself to make sales. And so I know one of the things you and I worked on and some of the other ladies worked on, well, if you already have a community, do they know that they can work with you for a cost? You know, you've done all this work to build a following in a community, but now don't be shy to tell them, okay, I have 5 spots open for one-on-one clients, or in 4 weeks, I'm launching my online program, a group online program, and there's only 6 ladies that are going to get in. And, you know, the first 3 that sign up today are going to get this bonus or whatever, right? You have to, and that's not sleazy. That's not spammy. That's not salesy. If you have done all this work to align yourself with your purpose and create this God-given work in the world, then you better damn well think that that work is valuable, okay? Yeah. And if you realize the value in creating transformation for somebody in that area is really priceless, then you should not feel any shame or any lack or any fear around telling somebody, hey, I do something that's so freaking valuable, I can't even tell you how much it's worth. And now I'm going to charge you one night $199 or $1,000 or whatever it is. That it's an equal exchange. You're giving value and you're giving out energy, and you should receive it back in the form of money.
Yes. Amen, all women. And I know that you're all about empowering women, and I am. And the word that's coming up for me are words around value and worth, and seeing the value and worth in women's work and the mutual exchange that's there, you know, like you offer your skills, your gifts, your talents, and you offer transformation, and you deserve to feel supported and enlivened in doing your work. So that's so awesome.
Yay.
I love that. Beautiful. Well, how can people learn more about you and find more about the Superfly program?
Yeah. So I'm all over online. So if you just type my name, which is Celia Ward Wallace, in Google, you'll find the million different places that I exist, and you can figure out which one of those places is the best fit for you. But my 2 websites, so there's one which is for the Superfly program. So it's thesuperflyprogram.com. And right now, there's a wait list for that program. It's not open yet to the public. It will be opening in the next 30 days, and we will begin our 8-week session on October 12th. And so if people want to get more information about that, if they want to get notified when we start offering the early bird bonuses and all, you know, opening the gates and all that stuff, get on the wait list there. Also, my website is my name without the hyphen, so CeliaWardWallace.com. And I have a bunch of free everything up there. You can sign up for all kinds of cool stuff. Also, I have a ton of inspirational videos and blogs and interviews there that are totally free that you can access. And then the last place I would say is on Facebook. I have the my free private Facebook group, which is the Superfly Society Mastermind. So if you just type that into the Facebook search, you'll be able to find the private group, and I will grant you access to the group. But most of all, just, you know, if you find this conversation that Kadidja and I have had, you know, valuable, transformative, my goal is for everybody who listens to have at least one moment of a shift in perspective, or one, you know, igniting of like an aha moment. And I would love it if you would send me an email. My email is Celia@CeliaWardWallace.com. Send me an email, send me a private Facebook message, and just say, hey, just saw your interview with Kadidja, and when you said X, you know, it meant something to me. I mean, that is what we do this for, is for those moments of knowing that we've impacted people's lives. And so while I'd love for you to join the Superfly program and get a chance to work much more intimately and one-on-one with me, because as you know, Kadidja, I'm very, very, very accessible and involved in the group as well as the call. I also would just love to hear from you, regardless of whether, you know, my business offerings are fit for you. I just want you to know that I support you. You don't have to be anything, have anything, do anything differently than where you are right now to be 100% perfect as you are. And the more that you just love yourself, accept yourself, and forgive yourself, and just really embrace the journey and path that you're on at this moment in time, that's where the peace comes from. That's where the flow comes from. That's where the joy comes from. And I wish that for you. I'm just sending you so much big love and blessings, and wishing you all the best. So please come find me and say hi and let me know that you found me through this video.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Celia. I can't recommend your programs enough. I so appreciate the work that you do in the world, and I'm so excited to introduce you to my audience.
Yay, me too. I love you so much, Kadidja. Thank you for hanging with me, and we will talk to you all soon. Bye.
Bye.